this is the reading for Sagittarius for the spring of 2017. I've changed my layout, my cards, the whole bit, so I'll explain that. I have split the cards into masculine and feminine energies. So for the feminine side, I'm using the goddesses and sirens oracle deck. And for the masculine side, I'm using the God and Titans oracle deck, both by Stacy DeMarco. The clarification cards, I'm using the Kuan Yin oracle deck for the feminines and the Voices of the Trees deck for the masculine side. And that's Voices of the Trees by Mickey Mueller. I think that's how you say her name. And so what I did was I put two pyramids, one pointing down, one pointing up. And I don't necessarily assign, meanings to each and every card. Hopefully you enjoy and hopefully it's clarifying. I want to take the moment to thank everybody for their likes, subscribes. My February readings went nuts. They were really good. I got a good response from them. They were the sex romance. I decided not to carry on in the sex romance. I wanted to get into deeper spiritual issues. I would like them to get their spiritual issues cleared out so that maybe next year or later on in the seasons we can switch to the love and romance deck. I feel like we have to get our spiritual lives under control before we can move into the sexual side of things. So that was my outlook on that. So I'm going to start with the feminines, and we'll go from there, and we'll just kind of see how this all works out. Now for the feminine, Sagittarians, we start out with justice. That, it's interesting to me, all the readings seem to carry from the last sign into, and there was justice in the last sign here of Scorpio, so we have that carried through here. It seems to be... The sense I get with it is that this is where we're coming from, a sense of justice. We carry on to peace and also to power. So that's a very good energy with peace in the middle. trying to figure out if this is an internal or external, and I feel like it goes both ways. For the feminines, I feel like they are wanting to see justice and carry it out outside of them, and are also seeking for internal justice and power within. So, on the second rung here, we have temptation and faith coming in. So, a lot of this temptation that I get this card, I feel like there is a sense of kind of that devil looming over your shoulder, tempting you to go in a direction that is not quite great and positive for you, or leading to that sort of outcome anyway. So there's a sense of that looming over it within the situation here. And then we have faith. Now, we end up in contentment. The contentment here, we have a woman looks like she's, you know, about to birth. The belly of the woman here in this card is really showing that, I mean, she's about to birth. And that is really, I get a sense from the energy that I'm getting for these Sagittarian women that there is something, I mean, there could be a pregnancy on the horizon here, but I feel more mystical about it and deeper in issues and spirituality, that it is really a birthing of a process coming to light for them. And if we go on the left side, we have contentment, temptation, and justice. Now, I feel like if the justice card is in the way, we may be tempted to do wrong, but we will still come out okay. We will make out okay with it. We may be indulging in the darker side of things, or indulging in a way that is maybe not on the right side of things, but that may be justified. There may be justification for that. We go on the left, or sorry, on the right side of things. I'm all backwards. We have contentment, faith, power on this side. So this is a very strong energy because we have the power, and faith is can go either way. You can lose faith or you can gain it. But we have peace. You know, I'm just seeing all the relations here. It is like these Sagittarian women are in the process of starting something, whether it's maybe a family, can be direct as that, or another line of being, meaning another way of seeing things, another attitude that they are coming from, or an awareness of something that they are. And I feel like this, if it's in the birthing process, just about, because it's not quite formed, it's not out. You know, it's still in her belly, it's still formulating. So the awareness here for these Sagittarians is not quite noticeable. And the temptation to stray from the boundaries, or maybe morals, and maybe lashing out on issues, people that are coming to them with issues that they are lashing out on. They have to kind of restrain themselves. They may be justified in that, but, you know, in a karmic sense or an energetic sense, we don't want to lash out to just to gain. You know, and that's an ego sense when you're lashing out at someone just to say, you know, no, that's bad. You know, because, and drilling it home, I get a sense of that with these Sagittarian women, like they're almost fed up with certain routes here, certain people that have come at them. And for the most part, I don't think they like to be combative. But when they're backed against a wall, that's where they go. And I feel like that's a possibility here. Peace is in the middle with the contentment. So it's almost like there's outer things coming into you, really throwing you off your game. Something from the outside comes in and throws you. You're in the middle of peace, in contentment, trying to figure things out, kind of zenning out, and there's sidewinders coming in and spinning you around. So it's throwing you off. So you're going to have faith that you have the power that it takes to overcome. Sit in the air that there is justice in the world, and have faith that that will carry itself through. And it does not have to be done by you. I think these women are sometimes going, okay, that's enough. Like, they haven't got their own. Like, I got my own problems. You deal with your own stuff. Don't come out at me type thing. So a little bit of squabbling back and forth. Also, just a high sense that these Sagittarian women are really in a good mode, and they've got some outside factors coming in and stirring things up. Now, I'm feeling, I mean, there's never not a reason for that. There's never a situation where you have something come out of the blue that, you know, you shouldn't have to deal with. If you shouldn't have to deal with it, it won't come to you. So I feel like these issues are there. I feel like there's a sense of innocence within these Sagittarians, like not knowing, being in shock of, you know, these things coming out of the blue. Like an innocence there that I can't get past. It's like, I feel like I don't deserve to even be involved in this, you know, whether it's a squabble or whatever. So in that way, and also being somewhat isolated from the situation, and the situation has to come a long way to get to you. That's what I'm getting, and I can't even explain it because the scenario is not being written for me. It's just squabbling that comes at you from a long distance away. And it's like, no, really? I don't want, you know. But in a sense, it is, you know, because that illumination process, that enlightenment, that inner knowing, self-knowledge, awareness of other people, the way they deal with things, that kind of thing, it's just not quite there yet. So that's where the innocence comes in, is just that vision of working on yourself to get to the lessons and the, and all of these things is backing up to a point where you really are, you just don't know because you're just not there yet. The timing is off. And I feel like even in the summer, we're going to be a bit lost and distracted. I think it'll be in the fall when your turn will come for the Sagittarian women to kind of evolve here and move forward spiritually because they will start to be seeing things differently. I feel that's what it is, and that contentment is really, you know, the blissfully unaware. That's really what that is. You don't know that you need to be looking at things. You don't know what you need to be looking at, and you don't know what. So it is just really lost on you. But in a contentment with that and a peace with that, that will shift. And also a faith that will have to adapt to that. So temptation is really, I think, what's going to spur you on to get you into that gear where you're going to be in line to work with this. But there is power in the corner, in your corner, no less. I feel like the timing is off. It's just not your time to be enlightened at this point. I mean, you just have fun over the summer, and then in the fall, that'll be your shifting time. You'll shift into more of an introspective sense of who and you are, and looking at those issues that are coming at you. At this point, issues is just like a foreign word to you, not quite picking up on any of that. So, and that's the sense I get here for the feminines. So they're really kind of just, they're in a peaceful state right now, and they're just going to be, you know, over the spring, they're going to start to illuminate to irritation, which means that's the beginning process of your issues coming to the surface. And if you don't know what they are, they just are irritations, and they're just constant. And if you don't acknowledge them, then you spin in that cycle, and you just keep getting more and more of that. So the illumination process will happen closer to the fall, but in the meantime, they are in content with their peace, and it is starting to get disturbed over the spring. Now, the clarification card is reveal the peacock beauty. So this card is really, I mean, she's sitting there playing a harp, and there's the peacock beauty. I mean, it's a silent, I mean, you just everything unfolds, and it's a silence. It takes your breath away. It's so beautiful. And I feel like that's where these Sagittarians, really have to understand there's silence and they're watching, but they need to start to speak. Also with the peacock beauty, that can be a signal of creativity. So there may be, it's having to do with the sacral chakra, and maybe during this time, the spring and summer, they are very creative and very illuminated in that area and are going outward with it. It's also a push to say, you know, don't stifle that area. You know, and also having to do with the throat chakra, they were saying in this card as well, is to speak from the beauty and creativity. So it's kind of a rounded card where there's a lot here. And the picture doesn't do it justice because she's just kind of plucking away at the heart and the beauty. But the word is reveal the peacock beauty. So it's like you see everything, but you got to hear. You got to hear, you got to speak. You know, and the music is the creativity that is in the background that comes to fruition. So maybe through the creativity process, that is how you find your voice to... maybe it's through the voice instead of through your eyes that you feel or see, you know, sense these things in a different form, creative way. So, waiting to be illuminated, basically, these Sagittarians. But the peacock beauty kind of gives a sense of stop and stare. So almost like a pause, but also, you know, don't leave the creative side, you know. If you want to stop and stare at the beauty, that's absolutely warranted. But get involved in the creative process somehow. Whether it's with your voice to speak eloquently, or whether it's with music to let that fill you, or whatever. So there's something there. It's kind of beautiful. I can't even express. It's part two reveal. But there's some inner workings of creativity there that you can absolutely embellish on, and that will help you in your path. May even help you stave away some of that energy. But there's a reason it's coming at you. It's because you are in the process to evolve here, and it's coming down the road. So we just got to get used to confronting those things. But this is kind of like the first hiccup that comes at you, and you're kind of, what? Eventually you start to get used to it, and then you'll start to play into it. Meaning, you will start to understand that, yeah, they're doing that, and I have that in me too, so I got to change that as well. So that's where the Sagittarian women are sitting. Now for the men. Okay. For the men, we have obstacles, beauty, and shape-shifting. Interesting. Okay. I feel like there is... these are kind of odd cards. Beauty is like there's this guy looming over this egg. It looks like an egg hatching or like a hatchling. And it's kind of dark. But I think beauty is, that's... Yeah, I'm getting a sense here that there may be some obstacles that are in the way of you capturing beauty. And I don't feel that as being, for the male Sagittarians, I don't feel that as being their own beauty, giving to their own beauty. I feel it is more a process of gaining beauty from outside of yourself and bringing it in. So a partner or anything that way, or even just visually attaining that, finding something in that way that pleases you visually. And that could be just for the senses, like shape-shifting. So this is a need for a different outlook, different perspective, a different way of being. As we move on, we have skill and communication. You know what? And we end up with focus. Okay, skill and communication and focus. So it seems like I'm getting... Okay. So there's some skill that is needed in communication and how you communicate. I feel like this is a work situation for these men, but I'm also feeling a lighter side of partnering situation where, because we have obstacles and beauty right next, and that it just is clashing to me. It's clashing to me. And the beauty, it's almost like there's a situation where they have a partner. Oh, man. That either they're not happy with, or there's an obstacle there that they're trying to get through, but they're just kind of putting up with the relationship, and it's not quite, I don't know, there's something wrong there. So there's an attitude shift that needs to happen. So there might be an ego situation. And then we get into a heavy energy where it's very focused and driven. Communication skill is involved. And this, yeah. Yeah, it's almost like if there's a partnership here, there needs to be more communication because there's obstacles here because of that, of non-communication. There's an outlook here in these men within their relationships. They are not talking, and they know what their problem is, but they are not going outward with it. They're just going to go status quo for now, because they have not fed up enough to change anything. And change is here. The shapeshifter is in the corner, working through the skill and the focus. So it is almost like that is the way that we should go here. And also the obstacles are coming from the lack of the communication. Now, the clarification card is transition and partnership, which is interesting because it amps up that romance relationship sector. And this transition and partnership card is very much a symbol of, this is kind of like a marriage, these hands are being tied in union. It could also be a symbol of, if we're talking about work, could also be a symbol of partnership, close ties in the workforce or friendship even. Really, I mean, it can go across the gamut here, and we're doing a general, so it's more than likely all of these options. But the transition, shape-shifting, transition, change is kind of the overall theme here. And I wouldn't doubt, okay, that maybe there's a relationship here that needs a change of an attitude adjustment or a change period, like this isn't working. And I feel like the male who is in the Sagittarian male that's in this relationship is really in the process of not being happy. But they are not communicating their needs, and it may either be because they know what the obstacle is, and they know if they go outward with it, then something's going to have to change, and they really don't want to change things at this point. They're happier sitting in their little bit of uncomfortableness and a little bit of not wanting these things, haven't got to a mountain yet, still a molehill. So that is kind of the position I feel within a relationship. It seems like there's some unhappiness here. It's not being communicated. Yet there's focus skills. So it's almost like, I think you got it figured out. It's just, nah, I'm not going to go outward with it till I'm ready to leave, or till I'm ready for things to change, or till I'm ready for that adjustment that I have to make or they have to make. And I feel like this is a dual purpose thing. I feel like you know that you would have to change and the other party would have to change. So, you know, it's uncomfortableness within the change itself. But yeah, knowing it's there and it's building momentum, you know, it's going to, as time goes on, it's just going to count itself down, and eventually you're like either going to leave or change or make the change that you need or ask for the change that you need or communicate the change that you need. So there's a lot of holding back here in communication, and I feel like you are very aware of the obstacle that you have. You're just not prepared at this time to go outward with it. You're just holding it in, holding it back. You have the focus. You have the skill to really do what you need to do. I mean, you're seeing it for all it's worth. You're just kind of unwilling to change. You know that that's what you need to do, and you're not wanting to do that, so that's why you're staying quiet about it. You just, I'm not going to do it because I have to change. They have to. It's all going to throw things off. So that's really what it is, kind of a stubborn, not really a stubbornness. It's just more of a passive flow here. In the area, but you're very much in with a partnership, and so be aware that that's a central issue, and the communication has to be upped. I don't see it over the spring doing that, and actually they're going through the summer past to the fall, so it's going to lag quite a bit. So those uncomfortable things or those things that you're not quite happy with are going to start to grow because you're not dealing with them and not putting them to rest, so they grow, and two, you're not you're realizing what you have to do, and you're kind of being lazy about it, going, yeah, no, I don't want to do that, because so, and that really is not in tune with universal energy. As soon as you get those hints, as soon as you get, you got to bring them outward and let your partner help you deal with that. If you do not give them that chance to help you, in a sense, that relationship is doomed to, because you're just not being in a partnership. You should not even be in one if you cannot divulge that part of you. So that is really what it is that has to grow to a point where the male is standing there going, yeah, I've had enough. And it will get to that point, but they're going, yeah, even winter, they're showing me snow, so there may even be a point in the winter where it will go that far. And so summer, I think you'll be distracted. I'm going into other readings here. I shouldn't do this, but you'll be distracted. And, you know, but those uncomfortable things will start to grow and carry forward. So, yeah. And, yeah, it's partner. Could be partnership, you know. Boss, you don't like what's going on, but, you know, he's going to keep building on those things. Because you're not letting them know. You're not letting them understand what's going on here. I'm uncomfortable here. So if you don't know you're uncomfortable, he's going to keep pulling the uncomfortable. So that's the thing. There's the communication. So, and just, I mean, try and manifest a good outcome. Try and manifest forward. I don't see any major... I see that you have more skill than opposition here. And you have more... I mean, the obstacles are there because of your inaction, or rather. The obstacles are there, and also lack of communication. There's beauty in the center here, and even though it's kind of a looming card, it just looks weird. I feel that that has the effect to put a little sunshine on everything. It's just really the shape shift. It's the matter of the way you look at it and the perception you take, and that is what has to win. And Sagittarians can get bogged down. I mean, they're usually happy-go-lucky, but they can get bogged down in some heavy crap and let that drag them, and then they get cantankerous and it's, you know, ornery. So you don't want to do that. You want to get shift into the right frame, and then you have all those things are on that side of shifting that energy. So, and you know, if I remember my readings from before, that is really where you were coming from. So I feel like you were coming from chaos. You're starting to deal with that. Deal with it more internally than externally, because externally it just doesn't do anything when you're in chaos. It just comes back to you. But when you start to internalize and flip it and go, what can I do constructively? And then you work from that. Then that's, you know, and I feel like this may be, and there also may be some personal problems here with partnerships. But I don't see it as problems per se. It's just something that the male partner, these male Sagittarians, are not happy with. But they're not willing to talk about it, and it's not detrimental. They're like, it's okay. If they don't have it, then whatever, I'm okay. I'll keep it going. But I'm telling you, it's slowly built. And it's slowly building over the season. So, but that is something that you need to work on, is communicating your problems with your partner at the stage where they really are at that. Well, it's no, it's not a big deal. So for the males, I think my advice would be to communicate when you have these things in your head as a little idea. And it's not, it's just irritating, instead of when it absolutely pisses you off and you don't want the relationship anymore, don't let it build. That would be my advice. So so try and do that. In the meantime, there is power here. It's interesting, there's power in the beauty. And I'm getting the beauty, but it's more the fact that it can illuminate colors, yellow and orange, you know. The fact that it can illuminate the whole situation in a better way, but it really does depend on the shape-shifting energy. So you really have to change your point of view and your outlook on things. So for the females, we've got some peace and contentment that's being disrupted and coming out of the blue. And so this is the start of lessons that are coming at you from the outside, so you're going to start to be illuminated to that, and just kind of maybe try and lay back into your creative side to not get so bothered by it. But at the same time, the process is coming for you, so it's going to be coming at a quicker rate. And for the males, yeah, they definitely got to change their perspective and watch out for little irritations in relationships that might have the capability, that, like I said, over a long term, just deal with them while they're the little irritations that they are, rather than deal breakers at the end of a six-month term when you're going over this daily. Communicate early all these things, and you'll get further, and you may even get more progress than you think you can. And that's a lot of what I find, too, is when you bring it outward, you really do make more progress than you think you can, and your fears are really less than what they amount to be, or your fears are more than what they amount to be. So, yeah, there's a lot of focus here, but we have to change our perspective, and I feel like attitude, it's like change the attitude. There is an attitude here, and we got to kind of lose it. And in the meantime, watch for these little irritations. Communicate them to your partner, and you'll be good, you know. And if they don't like it, then they'll, it's open dialogue. Give them a chance to participate in the relationship. That's really what I get from the Sagittarians. They're not giving their partner a chance to participate, and they're just bulldozing over everything and not. It's like, no, I feel this, but that's okay. I'm just going to let it go. So there's no opportunity to learn there for them or for their partner, neither. So that is the reading for spring for the Sagittarians for 2017. So again, thanks for all the likes and subscribes. I hope this gets people out of little binds. That's my goal here, is to try and help people and also dig deeper into your issues spiritually, and hopefully that makes sense to some and is not out in left field. So in the meantime, take care, have fun, and be kind.